Two vertices of a rhombus are 8 comma 0 and 0 comma negative 8. We're asked to sketch this rhombus. Remember, a rhombus is a quadrilateral where the opposite sides are parallel and all four sides have the same length. So this would be an example of a rhombus. Again, all four sides have the same length and opposite sides are parallel. Let's begin by plotting these two points on the coordinate plane, where the first coordinate is always going to be the x coordinate, and the second coordinate is going to be the y coordinate, again on the coordinate plane, where the horizontal axis is the x axis, the vertical axis is the y axis. So let's first plot the point 8, comma 0. So starting at the origin, because the x coordinate is 8, we would move right 8 units. Notice how the axis is scaled by 2s, so 2, 4, 6, 8. And because the y coordinate is 0, we do not move up or down. The point 8, comma 0 is here on the x axis. Next, we have the point 0, comma negative 8. So starting at the origin, because the x coordinate is 0, we do not move left or right. And then because the y-coordinate is negative 8, we move down 8 units to negative 8 on the y-axis. So negative 2, negative 4, negative 6, negative 8. Which means this is one side of our rhombus. There's an additional property of a rhombus we want to discuss to help us sketch this rhombus. The diagonals of a rhombus are formed by connecting the opposite vertices. So here's one diagonal. And here's the other. And these diagonals have a special property. They're perpendicular bisectors, meaning they intersect each other at a right angle here, and also they bisect each other, meaning this small segment has the same length as this segment, and this segment has the same length as this segment. Knowing this property will help us sketch our rhombus. Because we went down 8 units from the origin to find this vertex of the rhombus, if we go back to the origin and go up 8 units, we can find another vertex of the rhombus. So if we go up 8 units, we'd be here. And then to find this vertex, we went right 8 units from the origin. So if we move left 8 units from the origin, we can find another vertex of the rhombus, which would be here. Now let's go ahead and sketch our rhombus. Notice how all four sides have the same length and opposite sides are parallel, so this would be a rhombus. And again, the property we used was that the diagonals are perpendicular bisectors. So if we were to sketch the diagonals, this would be one diagonal, and this would be the other. And notice how they are perpendicular bisectors. They intersect each other at a right angle here. This segment has the same length as this segment, and this segment has the same length as this segment. I hope you found this helpful.